the episode's done a good job setting up that, you know, you need to be having your eyes dart around. You don't know what to focus on, you know? Hello everyone, it's Dan the Video Ninja. Welcome back to the Den of the Video Ninja for what is going to possibly be one of the last of my Inside Number 9 reaction video series videos. As most of you know, as probably all of you know, I have been watching a BBC anthology series called Inside Number 9. It was a show that aired 5 or 6 years ago, and it is the collection of these short little stories. Each episode has its own little story. It has its own narrative. It has its own set of characters. They're all unique in setting and theme and format, but the writing's been solid throughout the entire show, and I've been enjoying watching every single episode. In some cases, I try to maybe second guess the narrative because they can be a little twisty, a little Twilight Zone-y a little bit, although it's more dark humor and a little bit of naughty jokes here and there than Twilight Zone mind subversion. So that's what we're going to keep doing here tonight with the next episode in the 5th and final season. I'm going to be just giving you guys a little bit of a blitz of highlights of first time reactions, because I haven't seen any of these episodes before. And that's going to be that. Obviously, this is going to involve spoiling the episode a little bit and a lot of the really good parts of the episode. So if you're able to and you want to maybe not have the episode spoiled for you, check out the show. I believe you can get it through Amazon or however you it is that y'all get your shows. Each of these episodes are really meant for you to go in cold, not knowing what's going to happen. So if you want to experience it fresh like that, I recommend it. But if you don't care about spoilers, then you can stick around and hang out with me as we dive into season 5, episode 4 of Inside Number 9, labeled Misdirection. One of the things I've been hyping up about the show all month is that some of the narrative in all these episodes has a lot of misdirection in it. And now we've got an episode called Misdirection. So I'm already on my guard. Oh, this is a great start. What is this? What are you doing here, buddy? Magic tricks? Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this episode. I can just tell already. Ooh, this is a good one. He's gonna keep doing it, and oh, the episode itself is gonna trick you somehow. Well! What? What the hell? Okay, now we're getting goofy. Come on, what is this? Copying all his notes. Oh, wow. Okay, well. 9 years later, oh boy, here we go. I love how they're carefully not showing you how they're doing any of these tricks, just in this casual conversation. Okay, let's see where this goes. Had a hell of a first act there.
Can I have my ring back, please?
Ooh, he's good. Oh, magician's duel, I'm here for this.
Nobody else knows how it's done.
Not another living soul.
Yeah, everybody's got their eye on something now. The episode's done a good job setting up that, you know, you need to be having your eyes dart around. You don't know what to focus on, you know? I love magic tricks, by the way. So this is doing a lot for me.
It'd be my granddad.
I bet you we know who his granddad is.
Close enough.
Close enough. There's something else at play here. I know it.
I wasn't fooled.
Oh, weren't you? Now he's gonna turn his security system off and the dude's gonna run in and murder him. And get away scot-free. Also, there's a lot of saws right there. That's making me a little nervous.
Oh, it's about your wife, Mr. Griffin.
Uh-oh.
No, we were fine.
Oh, no.
Can you tell me your whereabouts? You said you were here last night. Can you prove it?
yes, I have it all logged on.
The cameras that you deleted, yeah. That's the misdirection, yeah. Oh, the ring! He switched the ring! It's the razor, and he's got his fingerprints on it. Ooh! Very clever. I love a good trick, and that episode was a really good trick. And I like that they just explained it at the end, and they basically dropped all the pretense that they had in the previous seasons and episodes and said, okay, instead of all this narrative trickery to try and throw you off or whatever, we're just going to actually make the subtext into actual text and just make it a magic trick. Pull the trick right in front of your eyes and then show you how we did it at the end. Obviously, it loses a little bit of magic when you show how you did the trick, but like most whodunits and Agatha Christie mysteries and Sherlock Holmes, seeing a trick that was pulled off right in front of our eyes and we didn't notice it and then having it explained afterwards can be fun. Nothing else needs to be said. It was a good trick. This is why I like magic tricks. This is why I like this show, because most of the episodes, anyway, have been kind of magic tricks like that. Like I said, though, they just dropped the pretense this time and said, okay, now it's an actual magic trick. More, please. More like that, please.